alongside Bob McKenzie and Darren Pang. And gentlemen, if you're a fan of the Vancouver Canucks, game one certainly ran the gamut of emotions. And how about Kyle Wellwood, a guy who was waived by the Toronto Maple Leafs in late June? He was waived by the Vancouver Canucks in the middle of October. And for a guy, Darren Pang, who didn't score a goal in game number one, no one had a greater impact in the opener.
You know, Gino, you always beware a little guy with great hockey sense, a guy that you'll never see his skating stride on any DVD sold anywhere throughout Canada. And he's a guy that's got a short stick with a bad curve and a wooden insert. But what does he do? What does he bring to the table? About five stitches up top over the eye. He lost a chiclet, just casually just hands that to the trainer right there. And he takes part in everything that happened in this hockey game. Drew the minor penalty there, set up the power play goal. He was all over the ice. He played 18 minutes and 30 seconds. He was a plus two at even strength. Zero shots on goal. Face-offs, he was 100%. Seven wins, zero losses, and 5.5 minutes on the power play. He really calms things down. He sets up the table and obviously compliments other players extremely well. But this was a game in which Kyle Wellwood was a real hero.
And while there were a lot of really good things that happened from the Vancouver Canucks standpoint in game number one, Bob, there was also some lack of discipline.